Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu. I've been running around level 2 for a little while, killing some random monsters, mostly the types you saw earlier, the garbugs and hoods, until I got my wizard and fighter experience up to 10 and 3000 respectively. I believe 10,000 should be enough to get us another fighter level, and 3000 will definitely be enough to get us another wizard level, so yeah, let's first head back to town to get our level ups. In this case, instead of going to the temple, I'll go back to the starting area just to show you how level ups work in that context. So we're back in level 1 now. To get back to the town, first we have to go up a bit, and then out here we can go to the right and we can fall down this hole. This hole works more or less the same as the teleports in level 2. You fall down it, and then when you get to the bottom, when you see the little heal shop on the right, you teleport back up, and you teleport to right above the entrance, which goes back to the starting town. So as soon as you pass by the heal on the right, you can see the little portal up here. And it's just a matter of pressing the spacebar at the right time to enter it, so we'll just wait for it, and just too late. One more time. Ah, too late again. One more time, come on, we'll get it this time. There we go. So you enter that cave and you end up back in the little tunnel you started out with. Now, just like before, this is a little bit tricky because there's a teleport involved in getting back up to town. I believe we have to go a little ways and then go back. There we go, and then we can go straight up. And we're back where we started. So this works a little bit differently than leveling up at the temple, because as you saw before, if we level up at the temple, you get 5 points in 3 of your predefined skills. So for fighter, it's strength, dexterity and agility, and for wizards we get 5 extra points in intelligence, wisdom and magic resistance. However, if you go back to the starting town and you go to the king to level up, and we'll do that right now. See, this works the same way the temple level up does, so you just get an extra level. In this case, we get the fighter level first, we become a battler, and the wizard level as well, and that'll be it. So if we look at our stats now, you'll see that the stats haven't actually changed at all. Instead, we've been given 4 coins, 2 for the wizard level and 2 for the fighter level, and it's up to us to spend it any way we want. Now, the total amounts to the same amount of points, because getting 2 coins will either get you 20 points in the major skills or 10 points in the minor skills. So in this case we'd get, for example, we could put 2 points in strength, which would give us plus 20 strength. Or you could put 2 points in, say, agility, which would give us plus 10 agility. It'll just amount to the same total amount of points you get extra. In this case, I'm thinking we might want to add some points to magic resistance, because that'll start becoming more and more important as we level up. And we haven't paid any attention to it so far. Maybe some extra wisdom? No, we won't be using a lot of items yet, so we'll get some... a little bit of extra strength, which is always useful. Maybe 1 point of intelligence as well, because we don't want to lag behind too much. And use the other 2 coins for magic resistance, just so we have a little bit to get started here. There we go. Now, after that's done, there's nothing else to do up here really. We can just go back to town. The only thing I might want to show you really quickly is the item shop, but you know what? I don't feel like looking for it right now. It's not that important. We'll go back down. Go back down here, and what was it again? Go straight to the right, or do we have to do the tricky thing again? I think so. Not always sure exactly how far you have to go down here to make the trick work. There we go. Now we can go to the right. And down. See, even I get confused in here. Oh, yep, we're there. You just have to keep wandering around until you find the ladder back down again. Nope. By the way, as you can see, after leveling up both our levels, we're now up to 14,000 hit points, so that's pretty significant. We can take a pretty big beating now before we start taking real damage. Otherwise, yeah, things haven't changed too much. The only thing worth doing right now, I think, is first of all getting healed up so we have our full amount of hit points, and seeing how much money we have left to buy some weapons. I would really like to upgrade my armor as well, but to get a significant upgrade we need at least, I think, about 6,000, and it's kind of a waste because we only barely just got these, this stud of mill one. And yeah, we really want to be able to do some serious damage to the boss in a minute. Oh yeah, healing. We were going to get healed first. We can do that up here. Ooh, 800 gold. That's a lot. But it's 14,000 hit points, so that's pretty good. Now we'll go back to the shopping area, and the main thing I want to upgrade is my sword, and if possible maybe upgrade my magic as well, but we'll see how far we get, how much money we have left. I think I picked up some stuff I can sell as well. No, that's not true. Nope, I already sold it. Okay, so we have a dagger now, so any upgrade is going to be worth it pretty much, but I think we want to go up as high as we can. I think we're going to try for a battle axe. Yep, that'll do. We won't have enough to upgrade our magic as well, but that's okay, we'll do that later. So now we'll equip weapon, battle axe, and here we go. Now we can do start doing some real damage. As you can see, it even updates the sprite, so the guy actually runs around carrying a little axe now instead of a sword. So that's kind of neat, especially considering how old this game is, that they put that kind of level of detail into it. So with our new equipment ready, it's time to enter the final tower for level 1. But you know what, that might take a little while, so I think I'll cut off this part here and show you the tower and see how well we do in the boss fight in the next one. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next part.